That is why whenever somebody leaves the body and become ghost, we offer the sesame seeds and water to them. Because that irritation, stress, insecurity, frightened feeling, it will settle down in the ghost. Even if you have body, if you are irritated, you behave like a ghost only. All you need is sesame seeds and jaggery. You will become human being. I have seen when people get irritated, how they become like a ghost and scream. The irritation in the stomach, ulcer in the stomach, this parasites in the stomach, when it gets triggered, the irritation is triggered, they become like a bhuta, ghost, and they don't know how they are behaving, why they are behaving the way they are behaving, why they are uttering the words they are uttering, why they are screaming the way they are screaming. Nothing. They don't. Actually, even they don't know. They just feel suffocated and wah, 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 wah. I tell you, just if you do the detox properly, cleanse all the parasites and microbes, your whole system will become such healthy, and kayakalpa will simply happen. You taking powerful cognitions and higher lifestyle, but not being sincere to it, is gaslighting yourself, destroying yourself. Insincere. I am always afraid of insincere people. I am not bothered about traitors, enemies. Enemies and traitors, I don't care. I never care about them. I don't bother about them. They can't do anything. I know them. I know how their mind works. And I can play with them. Playing with them is like a leela for me. How Krishna danced on Kalinga, the heads of Kaliya, the snake. Nothing can be done. Kaliya can't harm Krishna, and Krishna always wins the game. So this enemies, traitors, I don't care. But these people who are not sincere are the more dangerous. They are more dangerous. Who fall for their mood swings. When the parasites trigger in them, falling for parasites, they are the more dangerous people. I handle these people more carefully. People who fall for the parasites, mood swings, they are the demons. I handle these demons more carefully than the enemies and traitors. Because these people are not sincere to them. See, I have always seen when somebody doesn't come for the morning yoga, doesn't do the spiritual practice routine, I always know either this fellow is an enemy or a traitor who is sitting here waiting for a right time. I know these criminals and I handle them the way they should be handled. Properly. You can always see all the criminals, traitors, in the sangha, they will never attend spiritual routine. This is one common quality of all of them. Enemies and traitors, we have nothing to do with them, and they can't harm us. They only harm themselves. Forget about them. But people who want to achieve enlightenment, who want to be with Paramashiva, who want to manifest Paramashiva, if they don't become sincere, we need to work with those people. They need support, care, inspiration, sincerity, energy, everything. That is what I do. That's what I am doing even now. I can give you the long list of people who have intention but are not sincere in their day-to-day life to detox themselves, to cleanse the microbes and parasites. If they become sincere, they will simply manifest Paramashiva. I can give a long list. Almost everyone inside our sangha want to manifest Paramashiva, but they are not sincere to their decision, to their commitment. So they gaslight themselves and fall for mood swings when the parasites trigger. They fall for their parasites, become like a demon, devil. Bah, 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 bah. And they don't know what they are doing.